Good morning, students. In the previous video, we have discussed about the differences between covalent compounds and ionic compounds. Hope that it is clear for all of you. Okay. Now, already we have studied that carbon forms compounds by sharing its electrons, isn't it? And these compounds are known as covalent compounds. Along with that, we have studied one more thing, that is the number of compounds formed by carbon. It is greater than the number of compounds formed by all other elements. Carbon can form a large number of compounds, and the number of compounds formed by carbon is greater than the compounds formed by all other elements. Okay. Why carbon can form this many number of compounds? What is the importance? What is the speciality of carbon? Carbon is the only element which is forming this many number of compounds. About 3 million compounds are formed by carbon. What is the reason for that? About that we can study now. Okay. So mainly there are two reasons for the formation of large number of compounds by carbon. The first reason is known as tetravalent nature of carbon. Now we can study what is this tetravalent nature. The meaning of this word tetra is four. Okay. Tetravalent means valency 4. The valency of carbon is 4. What do you mean by valency? Already we have studied in 9th standard, isn't it? The number of electrons gaining or losing or sharing in order to get stability. That is known as its valency, isn't it? That we have studied already. So in the case of carbon, we know that its atomic number is 6 and its electronic configuration is 2-4. So the last shell contains 4 electrons. And it requires 4 more electrons to get stability, to get 8 electrons in the valence shell, isn't it? So, the only possibility for carbon is to share these 4 electrons with the other atoms. Okay, it may be hydrogen or it may be oxygen, nitrogen, and with any other element, carbon is sharing these 4 electrons, the 4 electrons present in the valence shell. Okay, that is what is meant by tetravalent nature of carbon. Suppose this is one carbon atom, these are the 4 electrons present in the valence shell. Okay, now only hydrogen atoms are available. So how this carbon is sharing electrons with the hydrogen? Already we have studied this, isn't it? It is sharing its 4 electrons with the 4 hydrogen. So these are the, we know that each of the hydrogen atom contains 1 electron. So each of these hydrogen atom has a tendency to share its 1 electron, isn't it? So, in order to acquire stability, hydrogen is sharing 1 electron of carbon. Each of the hydrogen atom is sharing 1 electron of the carbon. So, that sharing we can show like this. And as a result, each of these hydrogen atom is getting 2 electrons and they will become stable. Now, for carbon, it requires 4 more electrons. So, it will share the 4 electrons of these 4 hydrogen atoms. So, we can draw like this, isn't it? So, this is a compound in which carbon shares its 4 electrons with the 4 hydrogen atom. This is the electron dot structure of this compound. Now how can we draw the structure? Here carbon atom and hydrogen atom is sharing one pair of electrons, so that we can represent by a single line. Okay. This single line represents one single bond. So like that, here also a single bond is formed. Here also a single bond is formed. And here also a single bond is formed. Okay. So this is the structure of this compound, and the name of this compound already we have studied, that is methane. Okay. So in methane, carbon is sharing its 4 electrons with the 4 hydrogen atoms. Okay. Now suppose instead of this hydrogen atom, carbon is sharing this electron with another atom, chlorine. So what will be the compound we are getting? Instead of this hydrogen, carbon is sharing that electron with the chlorine. So instead of that hydrogen, we have to write here chlorine. Okay. So we are getting 2 compounds, isn't it? These 2 compounds are 2 different compounds. They are having different properties also. Put that in. So depending upon the nature of the element with which carbon is sharing electrons, we are getting different compound. Let us see one more example. Suppose carbon is sharing, instead of this hydrogen atom, carbon is sharing that electron with another bromine atom. So what will be the compound we are getting? Here there will be hydrogen itself, but here there will be bromine, and here it will be Cl. And this compound is different from other 2 compounds, isn't it? So here we got 3 compounds. So like this, depending upon the elements with which carbon is sharing its four electrons, we will get different compounds. So depending upon the nature of the element, we will get many number of compounds. So this is one reason for the formation of large number of carbon compounds, that is tetravalent nature of carbon. So the tetravalent nature of carbon means the valency of carbon is 4. That means carbon can share its 4 electrons, 4 valence electrons with the other carbon atoms. It can share these 4 electrons with the other carbon atoms or with the any other atoms like hydrogen, chlorine, bromine, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Okay. That is tetravalent nature of carbon. The next property of carbon, which is the reason for the formation of large number of carbon compound, is catenation. It is the unique property shown by carbon. No any other element is showing this property as much as carbon is showing. Okay. Catenation means it is the self-linking property of carbon. What do you mean by self-linking? Carbon can form bond with other carbon atoms. That is what is mean by self-linking. Carbon, instead of sharing its electrons with hydrogen or any other element, it is sharing electrons with other carbon atoms. Okay. And that property of carbon is known as catenation. Consider the compound methane, in which carbon is shared its 4 electrons with 4 other hydrogen atoms. Okay. Now, instead of this hydrogen, if this carbon is sharing this electron with another carbon atom, we will get the compound like this, isn't it? And in the second carbon, we know that there also 4 electrons are there, 4 valence electrons. Only one electron is used here, isn't it? Remaining 3 electrons are there. Those 3 electrons are used by other hydrogen atom to form bond like this. So we will get a compound like this, in which 2 carbon atoms are linked together. Okay. So this property of carbon, in which one carbon atom is bonded with other carbon atom, is known as catenation. Okay. So not only 2 carbon atom, any number of carbon atom can be linked with each other. For example, instead of this hydrogen, if a third carbon is linked, how can we show that a third carbon is linked like this? And in this carbon also total 4 valence electrons are there. So the remaining one electron is used here, 3 more electrons are there. Those 3 electrons are shared with the 3 other hydrogen atom. So we are getting another compound which contain 3 carbon atom. They are linked with each other. Okay. Then suppose instead of this hydrogen, the third carbon is linking with another carbon. Okay, here also 3 more electrons are there. They are used to share with the 3 other hydrogens. So we are getting another compound in which 4 carbon atoms are linked with each other. So like this, any number of carbon atom can be linked with each other. Here I have shown only the compounds containing up to 4 carbons. Like this, 5 or 6 or 7 or 10 or 20, 100, 1000, 10,000, any number of carbon atom can be joined like this and forming a straight chain compound like this, a long chain compound like this, that is known as straight chain compound. In these compounds, the carbon atoms are arranged in the form of a straight chain. So these compounds can be called as straight chain compounds. Okay. So this self-linking property of carbon, in which carbon is linked with another carbon atom, that is known as catenation. Okay. So only carbon is exhibiting this property. No any other element is exhibiting this property as shown by carbon. In the case of silicon, up to 6 or 7 silicon atom can be joined together forming a straight chain compound like this, but only up to 7. In the case of carbon, thousands or 10,000s, lakhs of carbon atom can be joined together like this, forming a long chain compound. That is the property shown by, that is the unique property shown by carbon. And that property is known as catenation. Okay. And in this compound, suppose instead of this hydrogen, if this carbon is bonding with another carbon, and in this carbon also total 4 valence electrons are there, one electron is used here, 3 more electrons remain. Those 3 electrons are forming bond with the 3 hydrogen. So we will get a compound like this. So in the first compound, instead of one hydrogen, another carbon is forming a bond. Okay, with this carbon, another carbon is forming bond. So we are getting a compound like this, in which four carbon atoms are arranged in the straight chain manner, and one carbon atom is acting as a branch. Okay, this carbon atom is acting as a branch. Such compound can be called as branched chain compound. So if one carbon atom is there as a branch, such compounds can be called as branched chain compound. Got that? So due to the property of this catenation, sometimes carbon atoms are existing as a straight chain compound, or sometimes they are existing as a branched chain compound. Is it clear? So due to the property of this catenation, sometimes the carbon atoms will be linked and form a straight chain compound like this. That means all the carbon atoms will be arranged in a straight line. Such compounds are known as straight chain compounds. Okay, but sometimes one or two carbon atom will be form as a chain, okay, or a branch. So here this carbon atom is acting as linked with another carbon atom in this manner. It is acting as a branch. This is the straight chain compound. In that straight chain, one carbon atom is bonded as a branch. Such compounds we are getting, they are known as the branched chain compounds. Okay, so sometimes carbon atoms are arranged in a straight line manner, they are known as straight chain compounds. And in some compounds, carbon atom may be arranged as a branch. In the straight chain itself, there will be some branches. Okay, such compounds are known as branched chain compounds. Then sometimes the carbon atom will be arranged in the form of a cycle, means in the form of a closed figure. That we can show like this. If only three carbon atoms are there, these three carbon atoms will be arranged like this in the form of a triangle. This is a closed figure, isn't it? Like that, if four carbon atoms are there, they can be arranged in the form of a closed figure like this, in the form of a square. So like this, carbon atom can be arranged in the form of closed figures. Such carbon compounds are known as cyclic compounds. Okay. So there are three different types of carbon compounds: straight chain compounds, branched chain compounds, and cyclic compounds. Whatever may be that, in all these compounds, carbon atoms are linked with the other carbon atoms. And that property of carbon is known as catenation. Okay. Then when we are drawing these structures, we have to take care one thing, that is the valence of carbon is 4. That means it can form 4 bond. Here this carbon is formed 2 bonds. Okay, one bond with this carbon and one bond with this carbon. 2 more electrons are there. Using those 2 electrons, it can form 2 more bonds. Okay, sometimes it may form bond with the hydrogen, 2 hydrogen. Or sometimes it may form bond with the other carbon itself. So here we are drawing with the hydrogen. Okay. So this is the actual structure of that molecule. Is it clear? Like that here also. If we are drawing like this, it is wrong. Because carbon, the valency is 4. So total 4 electrons are there. Here this carbon is used only 2 electrons. 2 more electrons are there. Those 2 electrons also can be used to form bond with the other atoms. So like this we have to draw. Okay. That means 2 more electrons are there. They are also used to form bond or used to share with other atoms. So like this we have to draw. Okay. Here also. Here also. Here also. Is it clear? So this property of carbon, in which the carbon atoms are linking with other carbon atom forming straight chain, branched chain, or closed figures, they are known as, that property is known as catenation. So catenation can be defined as the self-linking property of carbon to form covalent bond with other carbon atoms to form long straight chain compounds or branched chain compounds or ring compounds. It's known as catenation. Okay. So these are the 2 reasons for the formation of large number of carbon compounds. First reason is tetravalent nature. The second reason is catenation. Okay. Study this and write these 2 points into your notebook. Okay.